Hi everyone, I'm Arabdha. I lead the marketing side of Halborn, and today we have got with us Stader Labs. There is Anoothi joining us in. Anoothi, we would love to hear a little bit more about you and your background before I jump into what Stader is all about. So tell us a bit.
Thanks so much for hosting me, Arabdha. I'm really excited about this conversation. Hi everyone, I'm Anoothi. I'm the head of Terra NEAR at Stader. Prior to joining Stader, I was working for McKinsey Company in New York. And right before that, I graduated from Harvard Business School in the class of 2021. Before my business school stint, I was working as chief of staff to the CEO of Abbott India. And prior to that, worked as a consultant, largely in the fintech space. So I'm a big finance nerd, and I took all the finance courses in business school, started investing in crypto about 5 years ago. And when the opportunity at Stader came around, it seemed just at the right intersection of technology, finance, and the startup ecosystem. So really happy to share more about what we are doing at Stader and what we have in store for the users on NEAR.
You seem to be literally at the vortex of fintech and crypto. So it's definitely a very, very exciting space in general. So when I took it at Stader earlier, the first sentence that stood out to me was that you guys are a multi-chain liquid staking platform. So I want to take a few steps back and just ask you about liquid staking in general, and where does Stader actually come into the picture here?
So just for everyone to know, I will just share some broad context about staking versus liquid staking. So what happens with staking is that users give their funds, which is the native token of the blockchain, to the staking infrastructure solution. And their money gets locked for that time period, and they earn a passive return on the funds that they have deposited. So it is a really great way of earning passive income. But the only drawback is that, for the time being, your money gets locked with the contract. However, liquid staking offers all the benefits of staking without this drawback. So users get the chance to deposit their funds with, a platform like Stader and earn passive return on their native token while getting a mirror token immediately at the time of staking. So for example, if users deposit NEAR with Stader's liquid staking smart contract, they'll get an immediate mirror token, which is equivalent in value to the deposited NEAR. And this mirror token is called NearX. Users can then use this liquid token NearX to earn additional yield opportunities on DeFi protocols such as DEXs, lending protocols, yield optimizers, and even NFT solutions.
Thank you for that again. So the mirror token NearX sounds very, very exciting. Of course, you just talked about it. So tell us a little bit about the launch. What have been the milestones you've been up to with NearX as well?
We reached about $5 million in TVL in the first 48 hours of launch. And by the end of the week, we were able to clock in $14 million of TVL. We went live on three DEXs right at launch. So the NearX NEAR liquidity pool was live on Refinance, Jumbo Exchange, and Tonic, which is an order book DEX. And within the first week, we were able to reach $3 million in TVL on the NearX liquidity pool, and also became the biggest liquidity pool on Jumbo Exchange. We also had dual incentives on the liquidity pools on Ref and Jumbo for even further magnified rewards. And finally, we were doing some really exciting initiatives like Guild Wars, where we were offering additional rewards to the guilds who were participating with us to onboard more users. So what I can promise is that the upgraded NearX will offer all this and more with a really reinforced security. And excited to talk about all of that during the course of the interview.
Right. I mean, those are some really powered up milestones, right? So congratulations to you and the entire Stader Labs team as well for getting to those numbers and hitting those notes. For sure, it's a fantastic progress for you guys. On another side, I also want to talk about the collaborative work we did recently around the exploit found in the NEAR smart contract, NearX smart contract audit, and the steps we took to discover it and what you guys did to address the issue ahead. So Anoothi, would you like to tell us a little bit about the steps taken over here from Stader?
So on the 16th of August, we actually had a situation where a vulnerability in the NearX smart contract got exploited. And the exploiter was able to mint 20 million NearX by transferring NearX to his own account in a loop. And this was really a unique situation which was exclusive to the Near ecosystem. And all I can say is that, you know, we were able to catch this in really a matter of minutes. And we worked extremely closely with the Halborn team to fix this issue and come up with the upgraded NearX. The plan is to now undergo a really extensive audit by not just one, but three auditors. So we are working with Halborn again, and then BlockSec and OSEC. And in fact, Halborn and BlockSec are redeploying new engineers to audit this right from scratch and bring back the best, you know, and most secure audit process to really solidify the security infrastructure on NearX. While this has been, you know, the first step that we have taken, we are also taking additional measures and trying to build a multi-layer security solution for NearX. So the second thing will be a really strong bug bounty program in collaboration with Immunify. So once our auditors approve the code, that will be open sourced and white hackers can engage with the NearX smart contract and identify any vulnerabilities for which they will be given a really handsome price depending on the severity of the bug they identify. The third thing I would say is that we are rethinking a lot of internal testing processes and trying to bolster the testing process at every step, be it through peer reviews, be it through additional manpower deployment. And we are also thinking about plugging in additional functionalities in our smart contract for notifications and instant security updates. So that would be the third thing. And the last thing is that we're also exploring collaboration with you know, dedicated security protocols like HAPI and InsureAce to further explore any security upgrades that can be incorporated. And I can very confidently say that this will really set the gold standard in terms of security for a liquid staking solution on Near. We are really trying to learn from this mistake, you know, which could have happened with potentially anyone. And we're trying to make sure that this only helps us to set the right standards in security for the ecosystem over the long term. So I can rest assured users that the upgraded NearX will really have a very solidified and secure platform and will definitely come with all the rewards and exciting opportunities that we offered earlier and more.
Right. Thank you so much for sharing all these holistic steps that you guys are taking for us. Also, we do believe security is a very continual process, and hence adding all these extra bolsters to secure that up further is absolutely a great step in the journey of Stader itself. You talked about the upgraded NearX. Any milestones, anything new coming up there that we can be expecting soon?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, it has been a hell of an emotional ride for us at Stader, and it's a mixed feeling, but we are really thrilled to be launching the upgraded NearX. It has required a lot of effort from our end, and it will have all the security features that I just mentioned in terms of the three audits, the bug bounty, the strengthened internal security, and also potential collaborations with the security protocols. So based on all of this, we'll come back with a much more strengthened NearX. And we are looking at a launch timeline by the mid of September, if all the audits you know, are on track, and we receive no specific you know, red flags by the end of this week. This was a really hard call for us, and we decided to really put security paramount and give auditors the time to relook at the entire code afresh. And that is the only thing that the launch is currently contingent on. So that is how the timelines look like. We will be absolutely open to any feedback from the users. So if there's any concern that's top of mind for the users, please feel free to reach out to us on our Telegram channel, which is available 24/7. And we will try to address them to the best extent possible.
Right. All of that sounds intense and definitely very, very exciting. Also, for anyone who is hearing us right now on this video, feel free to AMA with us, drop in a line or a comment, and we'll be sure to get back on all of that progress. Well, Anoothi, is there anything when you look back on your own journey thus far from a security standpoint, perhaps, that you think, oh, I wish I had known that sooner? Is there something that comes to mind around that?
Honestly, you know, one of my biggest learnings has been humility and knowing that, you know, no matter, you know, how hard you try, things can potentially fall apart, but how you react in the aftermath of that situation is what truly matters. And so while we are going to do everything in our capacity and leave no stone unturned to really bring the most secure liquid staking solution to users on NEAR, my biggest learning has actually been keeping community front and center of everything we do at Stader. And in the aftermath of what happened, you know, we have decided at Stader to reimburse the users in full for the 165k NEAR that was lost on the LPs. And this was probably, you know, the easiest decision to make because our value system at Stader has been so clear. So my biggest learning has been that, you know, you can try your best and probably build as many buffers as possible as you are trying to launch a product, but keeping your composure and actually staying true to the value system of the organization, even in a crisis, is what has been my biggest learning. And what I can truly promise is that for Stader, community will always be front and center.
Thank you for, again, all the detailed steps that you have taken and sharing all that journey with us. And with that, I'll call it a wrap. Thank you again for joining us in, and stay tuned. Thank you.